So friends, we have completed the part 1 of the information theory. Now we are into the part 2. Here we generally speak about error control coding. In this video I am going to talk about what are linear block codes, and in the next video we will see what are convolution codes. These two are the basic techniques or basis for the error controlling in a discrete channel. Okay, so these linear block codes and convolution codes have their own importance, but most probably whenever it comes to the practical communication applications, we use convolution codes because it is very convenient to use, and moreover it doesn't have most of the mathematical operations as linear block does. Okay, so but we learn both about both these. Both have their own importance, but as compared to the linear block, convolution codes are used morely. Okay, now I'll start the what are the linear block codes. Okay, here linear block codes. The word linear defines nothing but it is the modular two addition of two different code words. Okay, here you need to understand few terms basically, and please concentrate on whatever I'm telling here, and if you have any doubts you can comment in the comment box. Okay, so first thing is the code word. Code word is a collection of different codes, it means number of bits. Okay, generally we give this as or write this as C1 C2 C3 and CN. Okay, it's a code word, or it is a code, you can say it is a code. Okay, next is that other thing we need to define is that whenever we are talking about the linear block codes, it is the operation or this error checking does whenever there includes an encoder. Okay, whenever we encode some particular information, then only we might get some errors here. So before speaking what is the process of this block codes, I'll define what some certain terms in the linear block codes. First thing is that we have an encoder which have two lines, one for the code word C as I already mentioned, one for the code word C. The input which we give is the message signal, right? So that message M. Out of M we have K info bits. Okay, K information bits which is sent. For K information bits we have 2 power K distinct values, 0s, 1s. So we have 2 power K distinct values or messages for that. Okay, similarly whenever we get to the output of the encoder, we have code word C and the number of bits we get at the output is N coded bits. This N is always greater than K. Okay, whatever the coded bits we have, because I'll tell you what will be the coded word, what all it includes. Okay, always N will be greater than K. Okay, now this here we have again for this N we have 2 power N distinct values. Okay, so this is the basic structure of linear block codes. We call it linear because of XOR operation between two codes. Okay, I can say this as modulo 2 sum. Okay, or else XOR. Both terms have the same meaning. Okay, so this is the basic structure of the linear block code. Now this linear block codes have certain type of matrices. This deal with the generally this topic deals with the matrix. Okay, it has type of matrices called, this is also a matrix, this is an array, so it is a matrix code matrix and message matrix and generator matrix, parity matrix and entropy matrix. Okay, I'll go on with the each and every matrix and I'll try to write the relations between them. Okay, these are just needed for us to get wherever to change the error bits in the message which we are sending and which we got at the output. Suppose I have sent 1001 as an message, but at the output I got 1000. Using these techniques I can get where the error is and I can change the error bit. As only I have two possibilities here, either 0 or 1. If I am sending 1001 as my message and I am getting 100 as my output, If I know at what location of the message I have the error, then I'll go directly to that location. Okay, as it is 1, it is 0, right? So what is the other possibility I have? It should be definitely, if this is the point of error, then it should definitely be replaced by 1 to reduce the error, right? So I'll replace 0 by 1 directly. This is the main advantage of going for the linear block techniques. So the encoder which I have shown you earlier generates the generator matrix of n comma k bit. So that generates n comma k block codes. Okay, that encoder generates n comma k block codes. I already told that at the output side we have 2 power n distinct values, but we take this 2 power n and we use only 2 power k values of this. 2 k values of this 2 power n to form the code. So n comma k block codes are generated and for every 2 power n we use only 2 power k values out of it. First thing is that first matrix I am dealing with is generator matrix. This is the technique which we are using, so there is no certain meaning why we are using these matrices and all while doing this technique. Okay, so it is defined and it is dealt the previously by Shanning or some other scientists. Okay, so they have formulated this way of designing the technique. Now here we deal with generator matrix. This generator matrix has, suppose I have a linear code. Say for a linear code of size 1 cross n, right? Of 1 cross n, I have the message of 1 cross k bits into the generator matrix of k cross n. Okay, 1 cross n, 1 cross k cross n gives me 1 cross n again. Okay, so this is the basic formulation of generator matrix. Code is equal to message into the generator matrix. Now this code is, I already, this c1 c2 1 cross n size n. Okay, similarly message m1 m2, it is m cross 1 cross k, whereas generator is k cross n, right? This generator generator is k cross n, which is given by g1 g2 g3 up so on gn as g11 g12 up to g1n. Similarly gn gmn GN1, GN2 up to GN. Okay, this is the generator matrix definition. Now, I already said that the whatever code which is generated is not completely of the message signal. It consists of two parts. One part has
parity bits.
The other part has message.
This is the message bits.
Okay, if my message bits are k,
then my parity bit will be n minus k.
Okay, so whatever my generator matrix I have to take as it as parity, and this is the generator matrix which I need to define. So basically whenever we solve the questions, parity generator matrix will be given, and from there we need to take the parity. Okay, and this is I is the identity matrix of k rows and columns. Okay, now
from this, if we consider the code m into g,
now whatever my code which I get will be having the message as well as message parity. Right, message and message parity. Now if I consider this as ik comma p, then
this is the case.
I have the message and message parity. If I consider p comma ik, then I have message parity and message. Okay, this is the code word which I am going to get. Now we'll try to do small example using this generator matrix to get the code. Okay, I'll consider one example as
generate the linear code. Generate the linear code
for, these are the given
matrices G
as
1 1 0 1 0 0 0 1 0 0 0 1.
Okay, it's a
0 0 0 0 0 1.
Okay, now the codes
which we they give as 0 1 1 1 1 1 0 0 1.
Okay, 101. This is a generator matrix, and they have given to generate the linear code for 7,4 block. Okay, now using this, we need to find out the, and also they given
message as 1110.
Okay, this is the information they have.
We need to find out this.
What is the regular procedure is
C equal to M into G, right?
Now for this I already know the message
1 1 1 0.
Okay,
the generator matrix whatever they give 1 0 1 1 1 1 0 0 0 1 0 1 1 1 0 0 1 1 1 1 0 0 0 0 1 0 0 0 0 1 0 0 0 1.
Okay, now row into column for every thing, for each and every row and column, if I multiply and if I see my output code, whatever I'm getting is
0.
So after solving this matrix, we get the code as
0 1 0 1 1 1 0.
Okay, so this is the code we get. Here don't consider this as addition of normal matrices. You need to consider the addition as modulo 2 addition. Okay, 1 into 1 1. Okay, 1 into 1 1, 1 into 0 0, 1 into 1 1, 1 into 0 0. So 1 plus 1 is not 2 here, is not 1 here. Okay, we are not applying OR gate here, we are applying XOR. 1 and 1 gives you 0. Okay, so similarly 1 into 1 1 plus 1 into 1 1 plus 1 into 1 1 plus 0. 1 and 1 gives me 0, 0 and 1 gives me 1. Okay, this is the type of addition you need to follow here.
Okay, as we are dealing with binary digits.
Okay, now this here we understood how to generate the code from the given generator matrix and the message. Now here if you see this, I have told you earlier regarding this thing, regarding the generator matrix. So what,
how exactly it is looking here is, if you can see here, it is in the form of parity and IK,
right? Now if I'll separate this, this is the IK matrix, that means I4, right? This is the I4, whereas this is the parity matrix. I'm telling this because whenever they give the generator matrix, if they ask you to find out the parity, first check for the identity matrix in the matrix, okay, in the generator matrix. Then separate the identity matrix, whatever the remaining part which is available, that is your parity matrix. They don't give the parity matrix directly in the question. If they mention, that is okay, but if they don't mention, you need to consider the parity, because this parity we use again for checking the parity matrix. Okay, you need to first separate the parity matrix, because I'm using the same example for the next two steps, I need to consider this parity matrix. Okay, I'll write down this parity matrix somewhere on the screen here. Okay, so let it here, I'll write it. If you can see, my parity matrix is 1 1 0 0 1 1 1 1 1 1 0 1. Okay, now so this is all about generator matrix and how to extract the code from the generator matrix. Now next comes the parity check matrix. Here in parity check matrix, it is denoted by H. Please do not confuse yourself with this H and the entropy H. Okay, that is different and this is different. Here this H is given by I n minus k and p transpose. So this is the reason why I asked you to write down the parity matrix separately. Okay, so whatever the, if suppose this is the parity matrix and if I generate this parity matrix, then this, to be a parity matrix, it should satisfy certain condition. The condition is that H n minus k cross n, this is a matrix of n minus k rows and n columns, and its dot is product with the g transpose, and it is the n cross k should be equal to 0. Okay, this is the important condition for the parity matrix to be satisfied. Okay, here we define the parity matrix, but for this matrix to be the parity check matrix, it should satisfy this condition. Then only we can say that is a parity matrix, okay, or correct parity matrix. Okay, now after this, to check the code, okay, that means this is for the parity matrix. The code words which we get, if you need to check whether that is the exact code word which we need to get or not, for that this code word should satisfy the following condition. C, 1 cross n matrix, 1 row n columns matrix, product with the H transpose matrix of n cross n minus k should be equal to my message of 1 cross k into generator matrix of k cross n into again H transpose of n cross n minus k. Okay, these both the products which I am getting, or any one condition you take, this should be equal to 0. So this is the condition for the code word to satisfy. This is the condition for the parity matrix to satisfy. Remember these two conditions whenever you are solving the questions on the parity check matrix. Now I will solve the question regarding this concept, and we will see whether this parity matrix which I am getting, which I am obtaining from here, is satisfying this condition or not. Okay, now we will see. You can check for the code word. As already you have got the code word 0101100, you place this code word and you try doing the H transpose of this and you check whether it is becoming 0 or not. It definitely will be becoming 0. Okay, now I will check for this condition now. So how to generate my H matrix here? H equal to I n minus k. I told this is the 7,4 block, right? 7,4 block. This is the n value, this is the k value. Okay, n minus k is 3, I 3. So I need 100010001. And P transpose. This is my parity matrix, right? So this parity matrix, I need to transpose it. That means what it becomes? 110. I'm sorry. Rows to columns. So 10111101110. This is my H matrix. I got my H matrix. Now I have to check whether this is the exact parity matrix which I need to obtain or not. I'll product it with the generator matrix. Generator matrix I have obtained in the previous thing, or is given the question. I'll write it down. 110 1000. Okay, next is 0111111110. Okay, 101 101 0100 0001. Now if I do the product of these both, I need to get my output as 0. Okay, let's check if we are getting or not. Okay, this is the G, I'm sorry.
This is G.
It should be transposed after this. So the same thing.
100 1011 0100 0011 1110 0111 into 1011 1 1 1 1 0 0 0.
Excuse me.
0 1 1 0 1 0 1 1 1 0 0 1 0 0 1 0 1 0 0 0 1.
So now each row and column, 1 into 1 1 0 0 0, and again 1 into 1 1 1 plus 1 0. Okay, so finally I'll get 0 if we do the multiplication in this part. So whatever H matrix I have obtained is correct, or it is satisfying the given condition. Okay, now after doing this, so this is my H matrix. You need to store each and every matrix which we are getting here. Okay, so this is H matrix. Then after this we will go for the syndrome and error connection. You need to remember this H matrix for that. What is syndrome and error connection? Now whenever this is a channel, okay, and whenever C is my code word I say, and I'm transmitting this code word through a channel, there will be certain noise in the channel which I will term it as an error. Okay, so an error. C is my input code word, E is the error here, and whatever output I am getting is R. R is a vector here. Okay, redundant vector I can say it. Okay, this R is C plus E. Okay, and so this syndrome matrix is defined as S equal to R H transpose. Okay, whereas R is C plus E H transpose. C into H transpose plus E into H transpose. Remember, the main important property of syndrome vector, syndrome matrix, is that it does not depend on the code word. Okay, so whatever might be the code word, it does not depend, it is zero. It only depends on the error pattern. Okay, so SC is given by E into H transpose. Now whatever H you have, you transpose it and you consider the error matrix of that, and you do the product, you will get the syndrome vector here. I will take the same examples and I will solve it for the syndrome vector. Sorry, I forgot to mention here, this is the syndrome matrix. Okay. Earlier stage parity 110. So this is something here. She missed out. I'll do this. Okay. Now